Hi guys, welcome you all to my channel Explore Edu to T. Today we'll be learning one of the most important concepts of control system called as the time domain analysis as well as the steady state error. In the last classes we have covered concepts like block diagram reduction, signal flow graph. So kindly go through those videos. It will be there in my channel's playlist. You can watch them if you haven't watched them. So please go and watch them if you have missed those. So today, as I said, we are going to cover one of the most critical concepts, that is the time domain analysis and the steady state error. These two concepts are very important from the subject point of view, from your university exams point of view, because you will find questions coming from these concepts. If you understand the concept well, if you do the steps properly, if you do the calculation, you are going to get good marks in this particular topic. Also, in the competitive exam point of view, when it comes to GATE exam and all those things, this topic is one of their favorites. Good, tricky, objective questions can be framed from this particular concept. So I'll try my best to make you understand the concept. The PDF which you're seeing here on the screen will be present in the form of Google Drive link in the description box. Please go and download it from there for your own reference. Pause the video. So let us start with the understanding of the concept. So initially, we'll be understanding about time domain analysis. So when I talk about time domain analysis, you understand that the analysis is going to be with respect to time as a reference. So there are going to be two important concepts in case of time domain analysis. One is the transient period. The other one is the steady state value. So what do you mean by transient and what do you mean by steady state? See, when you start a particular process, it takes time for the process to go from zero to a particular steady state value. So the in-between process wherein the process is moving from zero to a steady state value to a final value is the transient period. So if you want to understand in the form of a diagram, let us see over here. If you see this, this process starts from zero and reaches to a steady state. So the phase between the zero and the steady state is said to be as the transient phase. So the transient phase is the phase in which it is going to be between the zero to the steady state value. So let us read to what is given. The output variation during the time it takes to achieve its final value is called as the transient response. So from the zero to the time that it requires to reach or achieve its final value is called as the transient response. So see in the diagram, from zero to reach to a steady state value or the final value is said to be as the transient response, and the time that you require in order to reach the steady state value is said to be as the transient period. So I repeat myself once again. When you start from zero to reach to a steady state value, the process or the time or the response between it is said to be as the transient response and the transient period, and the time required to reach the steady state value or the final value is said to be as the transient period. So I hope you are very clear with the terms transient response, transient period, the steady state, so on and so forth. So there is one particular question which I have taken here from GATE EC 2006 paper. It is a very simple question, but that will make you understand about the concept in case of your time domain analysis. So if you see the question, in the system shown below, x of t is sine t u of t. So x of t is a sine signal, u of t is a step function. In the steady state response, y of t will be. So this is one of the most standard question in which you have the input x of t, in which you have the transfer function 1 upon s plus 1, and you have the output response y of t. So x of t is given as sine t u of t. So when I compare the sine t u of t with sine omega t u of t, because sine omega t is a standard signal, right?
So I can say that omega becomes 1. Now transfer function is given as h of s is equal to 1 upon s plus 1, right? Transfer function is given as 1 upon s plus 1. So we are writing s in terms of the complex. Hence we are writing 1 upon j omega plus 1. Now if I want to find out the magnitude response of 1 upon j omega plus 1, is given as 1 upon square root of omega square plus 1 square, that is 1. See, x plus jy magnitude is given as square root of x square plus y square. So similarly, x plus jy mein x is 1 over here and y is omega over here, and hence mod of h of omega is equal to 1 upon square root of omega square plus 1, since x plus jy is equal to square root of x square plus y square, is equal to 1 upon square root of 1 plus 1 is equal to 1 upon square root of 2, since omega is equal to 1. If I have to find out the angle, as we found out the magnitude of h of omega, if you want to find out the angle, it is going to be angle 0 upon angle tan inverse of omega. How do we find out this? As I told you, if x plus jy is my complex signal, my magnitude is square root of x square plus y square. Similarly, my angle is tan inverse of y by x, that is tan inverse of omega by 1, since my y is omega and x is 1, is equal to minus of tan inverse of omega. Omega is equal to 1, that is minus of tan inverse of 1 is minus of pi by 4. That is y of t is equal to my magnitude 1 by root 2 sine omega t minus pi by 4. So again, I'll explain you in short. See, x of t is my input signal, sine t u of t. I'm comparing this sine t u of t with sine omega t u of t, where my omega is equal to 1. My transfer function is h of s is equal to 1 upon s plus 1, 1 upon j omega plus 1, writing s as j omega. Find out its magnitude, as I've told you. If you don't understand, please rewind the video and see the formula that I've told you. You'll get 1 upon root 2. The angle will be minus pi by 4. Ultimately, your y of t will be 1 upon root 2, that is my magnitude, sine omega t, that is my input signal, minus my pi by 4, that is the angle. You can also write omega as 1 over here, that is not an issue, since my input is 1. So just summarizing what we learned, time domain analysis is the concept in which you have different terminologies. One is the transient period. Transient period is a period starting from 0 to a particular steady point value that it takes to reach to the steady point is the transient phase, transient response, and the time required for that is the transient period, that you can see from this particular diagram. 0, steady state value, the response between it is the transient response, and the period is transient period. Similarly, you have this particular question, go through it. If you haven't understood, you can rewind the video, listen to it again, download the PDF from the description box. You can understand it more well. Now we are coming to a very important concept called as the steady state error. Mind you, in the next lecture, we'll be having numericals and problems solved on this particular concept. I've taken a different lecture and a different video altogether for this particular concept, because I want you all to understand the numericals on this very well. Hence, for the concept, we have one video. For the numericals, we have another video. So please understand this topic very well from my video, from the PDF that I've attached in the description box, and get it understood very, very, very well, because every terminology is going to be of very importance. If you understand it properly, solving the numerical can be easier for you, because there can be really good tricky questions that can be framed from this particular topic in your university exam, and especially in your competitive exams like GATE and so on and so forth. So I hope you are very clear about the importance of this topic. So let's dive into it. So steady state error. The steady state error is basically, if you see over here, the step input is this, whereas the response that is obtained is this. So there is slight difference between the input and the response. So the slight difference is nothing else than the steady state error. So the steady state error is the difference between the expected response and the actual response. That is the steady state error. So when you give an input, I expect the output from it, obviously. So the difference between it is going to be the steady state error. So let us try to derive the formula for a steady state error. If you remember, I have explained you this block diagram earlier. If you don't remember it, you can watch my previous video. I'll explain you here in short. You have the R of S, which is my reference input signal. You have the E of S, which is given as R of S minus B of S, which is the error response. You have the G of S, which is the forward transfer function. You have the C of S, which is the output response. And you have the H of S, which is the negative feedback over here. Mind you, why did I say negative? Because we have a negative sign over here. So, trying to remove the steady state error formula from the diagram. Now, E of S is equal to R of S minus B of S. So, everything steps are a replication of my diagram only. So, nothing to worry. E of S is R of S minus B of S. C of S is equal to E of S into G of S. B of S is equal to C of S into H of S. So my E of S, which is equal to R of S minus B of S, E of S becomes R of S minus B of S, ke place pe we have C of S into H of S. Now my C of S is given as E of S into G of S. Therefore, R of S minus E of S into G of S into H of S, where my C of S is nothing else than E of S into G of S, and my H of S remains H of S. I will take this term onto my left hand side. So I can take E of S common, and 1 plus G of S into H of S is equal to R of S, and my R of S is equal to R, so, and my E of S is equal to R of S upon 1 plus G of S into H of S. So this looks a little complicated, but if you know the diagram very clearly, if you understand the steps very clearly, you can definitely derive till E of S. Now going to the derivation of steady state error. The steady state error is given as ESS. So understand its terminology, this symbol very well. This is a standard symbol used for steady state error, called as E of S. Now E of S is equal to limit of t tends to infinity E of t. Why so? Because E of infinity is because it is at the steady state value, and steady state value takes place at infinite time. So by final value theorem, we have the standard formula given as limit of t tends to infinity f of t is equal to limit of s tends to 0 s into f of s. So trying to replace my f of t as e of t, I have ESS, if you see from here, which is my steady state error, is equal to limit of t tends to infinity e of t is equal to limit of s tends to 0 s into e of s. From where do you get this thing? From the final value theorem. F of t gets mapped onto s into f of s. My e of t gets mapped onto s into e of s. I hope you are very clear with this. And hence we have the final formula E of ESS is equal to limit of s tends to 0 s into R of s upon 1 plus G of s into H of s, since my E of s is equal to R of s upon 1 plus G of s into H of s. My request will be, please imprint this formula into your minds, because this is the most basic formula for my steady state error. Even if you are unable to remember the other formulas of steady state error, which we will be learning further on, but if you remember this particular formula, trust me guys, you can derive any other formula. So remember, I am repeating, my steady state error, which is given as ESS, which is basically the difference between my expected and actual response, is given as limit of s tends to 0 s into R of s upon 1 plus g of s into h of s. I hope I am very clear with this. Similarly, just as I added input, my steady state output is given as CSS is equal to limit of s tends to 0 s into g of s upon 1 plus g of s into h of s into r of s. I hope I am very clear. Just remember this formula. It will be handy to you. Okay. So, now we will try to find out type of steady state errors depending upon the input type. Okay. So, as I told you, this is the basic formula. Once you know this formula, limit of s tends to 0, s into r of s upon 1 plus g of s into h of s, you can do it for different input types. Since my r of s is my Laplace transform of my r of t, which is my reference input, this r of t can be of different types. It can be a step signal, it can be a ramp signal, it can be a parabolic signal. So, if you know the basic formula, if you know how to find out the Laplace transform of the input signal, you can find out any other formula. Okay, so please understand this basic formula very well. I've told you regarding the derivation. Please understand from the video, download the PDF, take it as a reference. Surely, you'll be able to understand it. Okay, so let us derive for different set of inputs because its results are going to be very important. So, if my input is a step signal of magnitude A, my R of T is given as A. The R of S is given as A by S. Hence, my ESS is given as limit. Now, this formula, you know, limit of S is 0 S into R of S upon 1 plus G of S into H of S. It is mentioned above. So, limit of S tends to 0, S into R of S is A of A by S upon 1 plus G of S into H of S. The S and S gets cancelled off. You have limit of S tends to 0, A upon 1 plus G of S into H of S. Finally, I am applying the limits. A remains A, 1 remains 1 since they are constant, plus limit of s tends to 0, g of s into h of s, given as a upon 1 plus kp. So, remember that in case of my steady state error, if my input is the step input having magnitude as a, my steady state error is given as a upon 1 plus kp, wherein my kp is equal to limit of s tends to 0, g of s into h of s, and it is known as position error coefficient. I hope I am very clear with the first input. Let us go for the second input. If my second input is a ramp signal with magnitude A, my R of T or my reference input is given as A of T. That is my Laplace transform R of S is given as A into gamma 1 plus 1 upon S raised to 1 plus 1. The formula basically of the Laplace transform it is. So, when you have t raised to n as my input, my Laplace transform is given as gamma of n plus 1 upon s raised to n plus 1. Here, since my t raised to n, n is 1, I have this formula. So, this is nothing else than the Laplace transform. You can do it. Now, ESS is equal to limit of s tends to 0, s into r of s, 1 plus g of s into h of s. See guys, again and again the basic formula is used. It is nothing great. Just the thing is that if you know the basic formula, you have to put the R of S value, that is A upon S square. Just do the normal mathematics. S gets cancelled. S remains over here. Bring that S in the denominator. You get limit of S tends to 0, A upon S plus S into G of S into H of S. Apply the limits. A remains constant, so it doesn't get affected. Limit of s tends to 0, s. If you put s as 0, you will get 0. And if you apply limits to this term, s into g of s into h of s, you get limit of s tends to 0, s into g of s into h of s. That is A upon kv. So, I can say for my ramp input, when my input is of magnitude A and the expression is A of t, my ESS is given as A upon kV, that is kV is equal to limit of S tends to 0, S into G of S, where my kV is the velocity error coefficient. I hope I am very clear. So remember, if the input is a step signal with magnitude A, my steady state error is given as A upon 1 plus Kp, where Kp is the position error coefficient, equal to limit of s tends to 0, g of s into h of s. If my input is a ramp signal, then standard is given as A of t, then my steady state error is given as A upon Kv, where Kv is equal to limit of s tends to 0, s into g of s into h of s, that is my velocity error coefficient. Similarly, if I have my input as parabolic signal input, my R of t is given as A t square by 2. Again, R of s is the Laplace transform, A by 2, gamma of 2 plus 1 upon s raised to 2 plus 1, A by 2 into 2 factorial upon s cube is equal to A upon s cube. So A upon s cube is nothing else than the Laplace transform of my input of my parabolic signal, A into t square by 2. So your steady state error is given as limit of s tends to 0, s into R of s upon 1 plus g of s into h of s. Again, the basic formula, put R of s value as A upon s cube. Do the normal mathematics as we did for the other inputs. You will end up getting ESS is equal to A upon Ka, wherein your Ka is nothing else than limit of s tends to 0, s square g of s into h of s. That is my acceleration error coefficient. So after all this derivation we did, the basic important thing that you need to remember is this. So the first formula that you need to remember is this formula. ESS is equal to limit of s tends to 0, s into R of s upon 1 plus g of s into h of s. So if any input is given to you, apart from the standard signal such as the step, ramp, parabolic, you can find out the Laplace transform of that input signal, R of t as R of s. Substitute over here and you will get the answer. Okay. So remember this inputs. If my input is step, my out ESS is given as A upon 1 plus Kp, wherein my Kp is equal to limit of s tends to 0, g of s into h of s, which is my position error coefficient. Ramp is given as A upon Kv, wherein my Kv is given as limit of s tends to 0, s into g of s into h of s, which is my velocity error coefficient. And if it is a parabolic input given as at square by 2, then I have my error given as A upon Kv, wherein my A upon Ka, wherein my Ka is given as limit of s tends to 0, s square into g of s into h of s, which is my acceleration error coefficient. So I hope I am very clear with this. Then you have the type of the system. Now the type of the system is basically defined as the number of poles at origin of an open loop transfer function g of s into h of s. So always remember guys, g of s into h of s forms the open loop transfer function. If you want the closed loop transfer function, I have told you in the last class, it is g of s upon 1 plus g of s into h of s, provided it is a negative feedback. Okay. So if you want to, if from open loop transfer function, that is g of s into h of s, if you want to find out what is the type of the system, get the particular open loop transfer function, that is my g of s into h of s, in the standard format as given over here. And from there you can find out, because it's actually defined by the number of poles at origin. If you see the first type, here there is no S term, I mean a singular S term. So it is type 0 system. When I talk about type 1, if you see here, there is a single S with order as 1. That means it's a type 1 system. If I talk about type 2, there is a S square. This 2 indicates type 2. So whenever a particular open loop transfer function, that is g of s into h of s, is given to you, and they are telling you to find out the type of the system, you can definitely find out from this. So get it into the standard format as this and see how many poles exist at origin. Here there is 0, so type 0. Here there is 1, we have type 1. Here there is 2 and we have type 2. So in such a way, we can understand the type of the system. So concluding today's class with just a brief summary, we learned about time domain analysis, what is transient period, what is transient response, what is steady state value. We did a small numerical on a time domain analysis, which is normally asked in exams like GATE. Then we understood the steady state error meaning, which is the difference between the expected and the actual response. We did a derivation on steady state error, the most important formula. Again, I'm repeating again and again, limit of s tends to 0, s into r of s upon 1 plus g of s into h of s, where my r of s is the Laplace transform of my reference input r of t. G of s into h of s is my open loop transfer function. If you understand this well, you can find out all other steady state error irrespective of whatever is the input, provided you are able to find the Laplace transform of the given input. Then you have the output, steady state output, and you have the standard formula for the kind of inputs which is there. I have shown you the derivation, I have shown you the formula. Please remember those, because in the exam you might directly get that, okay, so and so is the step signal, what is the steady state error? So if you remember the formula directly, it will be very easy and quick for you. And then you have the way to identify the type of the system, which is nothing else than the number of poles at origin for an open loop transfer function, mind you, not for a closed loop transfer function. So I hope I am very clear. I please request you to download the PDF from the link given in the description box. Listen to this video once again, make notes from it, and I'm sure you'll be able to understand the concepts clearly. Do not forget to watch the next video, which will be uploaded very soon, because it's going to be dependent upon this particular topics and concept. If you don't know this concept, it'll be difficult for you to solve the numericals over there. Okay, so please understand the concepts very well. If you like this video, please give like, share, comment, subscribe to my YouTube channel, follow me on Instagram, and share this particular video to as many people as you feel can get benefited out of it, which can help them in their education and further on in their career. So God bless you. All the best, guys.